Hello and welcome to a special celebration episode. 10 years ago, Formerly E ventured into existence, defying all odds and skepticism. This is the epicenter where elite motorsport meets sustainability. And today, we want to bring you 10 exciting chapters where we look at 10 ways that this series, the all-electric race car series, is defining our future cities. In the early days of Formula E, skepticism was rife. Electric cars were still struggling with many preconceptions. Limited range, long charging times, lack of speed. How would this ever make a race lover's heart beat higher? Well, the past decade has put the brakes on that. And today, the series attracts the world's best racing talents and boasts the biggest lineup of car manufacturers of any world championship. And away from the racetrack? Well, new models of all shapes and sizes are wheeling into the market almost every day. Costs are falling, range anxiety is receding, and from electric SUVs to sports cars to small compact EVs, people have shifted their focus towards electric mobility. In fact, studies show that more than half of all people plan to buy a car now choose either a fully electric, plug-in hybrid, or a hybrid vehicle. Clearly, attitudes are changing from red to green. Will my battery cover the distance I need to drive? The first and biggest concern of anyone driving an electric vehicle is range anxiety. When Formula E started, it was the same for the racers. During the first four seasons, batteries would not last a whole race. Drivers had to switch cars halfway through. Pit stops became swap stops. And thanks to improved battery chemistry technology and growing batteries, range anxiety slowly becoming a thing of the past. Nowadays, commercially available electric road cars can offer a range of up to 685 kilometers. The average American drives just under 60 kilometers per day, and the average European, even less than half of that. A pit stop to recharge on the way to work? Not anymore. So, let's talk about power. Battery power and efficiency lay the ground for improved range. The latest Gen 3 Formula E race cars boast a staggering 350 kilowatt power pack. That is a 75% increase compared to the original Gen 1 model. The tech research of the first 10 years of electric racing has amped up performance, and its achievements catalyzed the battery technology in road vehicles as well. The battery capacity of the Nissan Leaf, one of the world's most popular electric cars, has increased by 181% since the start of Formula E in 2014. And just this year, the breakthrough in solid-state battery technology is likely to be a further game-changer. Solid-state batteries are safer, can power the car over longer distances, and cut production costs. The lights turn from red to green. Who's going to win, you or me? Well, if you're in an electric car, race or road, fear not, these are the fastest and the quickest accelerating cars on the planet. Now, one of these Formula E cars, we could reach a top speed of 322 kilometers an hour. That is a whopping increase of almost 100 kilometers an hour since 2014. And I know you want to know, the 0 to 100, right? 2.8 seconds, amazing. Now last year, Jake Hughes, a Formula E race driver, he smashed the indoor land speed world record by more than 50 kilometers an hour, and he reached a top speed of 218.71 kilometers an hour. You want to know about the car, specifically designed? It featured 3D printed body parts to optimize aerodynamics, and those tires, softer and grippier for enhanced straight line speed. But even if you were not in that vehicle, and you are one of the mainstream electric roadsters that do not claim high performance, at that red light, when it goes green, that 0 to 100, trust me, less than 5 seconds. I'm sure you've come across a criticism that electric vehicles are less sustainable than suggested. Commonly, people fault electric cars for the huge amounts of metals that are needed to produce the lithium-ion batteries. Recycling rates for these batteries have been very low, at less than 5%. But with Formula E leading the way, that figure is increasing with time and innovation. All Formula E car battery cells are given a second life after use, and over 80% of the battery's minerals can be recycled and reused. The Julius Baer research team assumes that 95% of all end-of-life batteries will enter the recycling process eventually. And by the middle of the century, recycling will be able to cover most of the demand for battery metals. and the recycling loop will be closed, a step paving the way for genuinely sustainable electric cars. When Formula E thrust out the blocks in 2014, it sought to speed up general sales of electric vehicles. But fewer than 500,000 electric cars were sold when the Gen 1 car cut through the streets. Our researchers project that by 2030, 75% of all new vehicles sold across the world's major car markets in China, United States, Europe, will be electric. Another 20 years later on, in 2050, well, it will even be 95%. The market is definitely electrified. It couldn't be more fitting that the very first Formula E race was held in Beijing in 2014. And in the 10 years since, China has gone on to play a leading role in the electrification of the car industry. It is now the world's largest maker and market for electric vehicles. 76% of the global electric vehicle battery supply stem from Chinese manufacturers. And around 1 in 3 cars in China currently come with a plug. And the People's Republic is investing in the future of electric car racing too. Hainan Province recently announced plans to build a venue worth $700 million to host events such as the Formula E World Championship. What's the one thing that you don't have time for when you're trying to drive? Waiting for your car to charge up. And that doesn't matter if you're on the racetrack at Formula E or your commuter trying to get to work. Here's what's changing, and changing quickly. First of all, charging points. As of last year, there were 2.7 million charging points worldwide. That's a 55% increase, and the trend is only going that direction. Second, how quickly it charges up. If you're charging at home, most EVs charge in just 6 to 8 hours. And these public, ultra-fast charging ports, they can give you 300 kilometers in just 10 minutes. So the trend is clear. We're getting you on the road faster and quicker. Formula E drivers may compete for the inside line on 4 recyclable tires and 2 axles. However, electric vehicles are not limited to that. Did you know that two-wheelers, mopeds, scooters, and motorbikes account for about 30% of global mobility? Here too, increasing range and falling battery costs and supportive policies are all creating a buzz with consumers, especially in China, South Asia, and Southeast Asia. By 2030, 30% of two-wheelers will be electric. And the two-wheel market is set to be worth well over $200 billion. It's no coincidence that Formula E organizers have chosen to race mainly on street circuits. From the outset, the races were placed in the middle of the world's greatest cities like Beijing, Berlin, Paris, and London. The championship has always had a clear aspiration to showcase how clean transport can improve the quality of living in our cities. The series contributes directly to clean air in all its race regions. It invests in projects that offset emissions and ensures the recycling of tires, batteries, and broken chassis. Still, its legacy goes beyond its own net zero carbon footprint. Formula E brings together industry experts, public authorities, and mobility specialists to tackle issues resulting from overpopulated and heavily polluted cities. It works with cities to improve infrastructure and raise awareness of the benefits of electric vehicles. In the end, electric mobility is one of the most effective means of tackling urban air pollution. Looking back, the first 10 years of Formula E have been nothing but groundbreaking. I hope we're able to guide you through some of the highlights that the race series have brought on and away from the tracks. I don't know about you, but I'm feeling quite inspired, not just for what has been, but for what is yet to come. And with that, this wraps up this particular series. I hope you've enjoyed it. We'll see you next time.